to another edition of Two Dudes and a Mexican. I am your host, Premier League Yanker, Victor Salazar. To the left of me, another dude, Pacta Sports Scott, Peter Soprano.
What up, what up?
To the right of me, resident Mexican, Dave Quiñones.
Orale, mi gente.
We got,
Buenos dias.
We got new toys.
G-Men.
Even though we saw. Shalom. Or top of the morning to you. I don't know, what's Pete say? COVID sucks, go Titans.
I like that.
Well, we're live from Dunellen, New Jersey. We are in Pete's basement.
Where the hell is Dunellen?
Dunellen.
Dunellen.
That's not our song.
Yeah. That wasn't our song. That's Lil Wayne. Yeah, that was Lil Wayne and Big Sean.
Just so you don't take it down.
That's actually the NBA Finals song, by the way.
Yeah, so they stole it.
So they stole it.
But we're live from Dunellen. What is it?
Dunellen.
What the?
Denali.
UConn Denali?
Denali.
Denellen, New Jersey.
We're live from the Titan Room.
We're live from the Titan Room.
Titan Room, baby.
And Pete's basement.
It up, baby. We opened it up today.
Pete's basement. Pete's got the money. Pete's got the hoes. I mean, attractive, attractive women. Attractive women. Excuse me. Is this COVID tested? I brought my mask.
Yes, it is. It's been cleaned right before you guys came in.
Take our temperature,
take my mask. Take my mask. All right, so we got a good show for y'all today.
Fuck you, Matt. Got here first.
Good point. Okay. Behind us, we got Premier League. On the side, we got NFL countdown, in case you guys care. You know, this is Pete's house, by the way. Amazing. Yeah. Amazing. I'm gonna
beautiful house, man.
His door was locked, and we just walked right in, so... definitely gonna
steal. Yeah, you gotta show the Titan stuff, yeah.
I'm definitely gonna steal some shit before I go.
He's like,
but here we go. All right, so little rundown of the show. Again, we're gonna talk a little bit about the NBA Finals. Baseball's in full swing. As you can see, I got my Yankee mask. And of course, Sunday Fun Day means we're gonna talk football and all the bullshit that's happened this week in football because of COVID, because of y'all president. not my president, y'all president. But let's get right into it. NBA's final has started. NBA finals are over. End the conversation.
Yep.
That's all right, let's move on. Great.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so.
On now next season.
Now that we got.
Draft you guys.
Draft
I told
time.
You guys. I told you.
NBA draft time.
We'll get back to you in April or when's the draft?
They don't even know.
We don't even know when the draft is. All right. So, first round of the playoffs of the MLB playoffs are in the books.
Yep.
Yankees. As you can see, the map.
Move on.
Braves, Dodgers, Rays, Astros, and the what? The Marlins.
Yo, Cubs. Really, Cubs?
The Marlins.
Really, Cubs?
The Marlins.
Are you serious, Chicago?
The Marlins sweep. So two games and then Mike, Padres, what are you doing? A's win. But shout out to Derek Jeter, right? Traded away Osuna, Yelich,
Stanton.
And Castillo. Look who's in the playoffs 2 years later.
Castillo.
The bottom feeders. Clap it up for Derek Jeter. All right, so let's go, Dave.
Crazy.
I'm going to throw this to you since you're on the outside looking in. There's no partisanship.
Yes, there is.
I'm non-biased.
Yes, there
I'm
is.
I'm non-biased.
Well, we're still in it. You're not.
Baseball fan right
he now. Wanted to knock down the Atlanta wall already.
So, I mean,
no,
cool.
I wanted to knock down a couple pictures.
Wow, this is delicious. This is delicious Coke Zero. Delicious. In case anyone's wondering.
It's like pineapple juice. Sorry,
Dave. Dave's a fucking alcoholic over here.
Yeah,
we lost connection. Yeah, your basement sucks, dude.
But Spreaker's still going.
Exactly. All right.
You go.
Yeah.
All right, so who makes the AL and NL Championship Series, Dave, out of the eight teams that I mentioned?
All right, so I'm going to start with the NL.
Oh, that's right, we got new toys.
I'm going to start with the NL. So I think the Braves will make it to the NL Championship. So I'll be honest, I thought their biggest hurdle was probably Cincinnati, obviously because of Cincinnati's pitching.
They're one-two
punch, but
Barrow's going to be a break next year. So fuck.
And because you know, again, on a three-game series, it's anybody's pretty much series. Once you win that first game, I mean, I don't know what the percentages are. Probably 90-something percent that you're going to win the series. So obviously, the Braves are here. I think they make it to the NL Championship against, of course, my pick to win the World Series. I told you guys, the Dodgers. Even though I think it's going to be an exciting, you know, series against San Diego. San Diego, obviously, you know, they bring a lot to the table with Fernando Tatis, you know, Machado. So their pitching is young, but, you know, they're pretty good. So for my NL, like I said, I think it's the Braves and the Dodgers on the AL side. Yeah, listen, I'm going to go with the Yankees.
Wow.
Outside just because, listen, you know, I think that offense,
wow,
you know, wins it for this series, even though I'm a little iffy on their pitching. past Cole, I mean, you really don't have much. Tanaka didn't look good, game two. But listen, that offense is, even though statistically I don't think they were the best offense this year. I think it was the Braves this year. But I think in the playoffs, that offense is going to, be able to overcome a lot of bad pitching. So I'm going to go with the Yankees.
Dave is changing.
And I'm going to go with the A's. I think Yankees and A's. I like the Athletics. I like how they got past the Chicago White Sox. I had the White Sox actually winning that series. But listen, the A's, I think they find a way. I'm not sold on Houston. I don't think that they're that good of a team. And, that's my pick.
Mm-hmm. All right, that's cool. I'm going to disappoint everyone. Sorry, guys. Although I love the Yankees.
Don't do it!
I just looked.
Where's the flag?
Wow.
Even though this is baseball, where's the flag?
No, you need a challenge. You need the phone challenge.
I love you guys. I love the Yankees. Wow. I love the offense. I hope I'm wrong.
No way.
I don't trust Aaron Boone as a manager. Something's wrong. Yeah.
That's a good point.
I just don't. Game two was scary. Like, one, why was Tanaka back in the game? I get it. He settled down. But any pitcher that takes an hour off usually doesn't come back in the game. Two, why Chapman in the ninth when you're – they were down, right? They were down one.
It was a it was a tie game, I think.
Okay.
But they brought him in, it was tie.
Either way.
They were down, though.
But you don't bring a closer unless you're winning. Like,
you only bring – whatever.
But
I get it.
But it worked, though. They won.
Things work that aren't supposed to happen.
A broken clock is right twice a day.
The Braves won game one. I mean, they probably should have lost game one.
Yeah.
But they won game one.
Yeah.
It's just,
and that's why I still blame Snicker for it.
I know, but sometimes you need a little luck on your side. Things happen, and I just think that Yankee offense is way too scary, man.
It is, but at the end of the day, here's what I
kind of like the Chiefs in football.
Right. Right, but the Chiefs...
Comes down to management, though.
Comes down to management. And here's the thing. Yankees don't know how to bunt. Yankees don't know how to hit and run.
But who does? Who does right now?
The Rays.
Right now. The Rays.
Nah, the Braves don't know.
The Rays.
No, Rays. They said Rays.
Oh, okay.
The Rays. Small ball.
Yeah, he said Rays.
Small ball.
The Braves don't know how to
do. I'm going to go Rays in five.
Braves don't know.
I'm going to go Rays in five. Unfortunately. I hope I'm wrong. If I'm wrong... I'm aware, five.
Okay.
I'm aware the mask the whole show if I'm
That's
wrong.
Gonna be a crazy game five.
That is. Oh my god.
And then the other one, I got
need to meet up then.
I got the Strohs in the other one. I got the Strohs.
Mm.
I think they're on.
You need to show them.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well,
you don't want to see it on the other
side. Rays and Strohs.
Rays and Strohs.
I think the Strohs are on there.
Where
are
you back on?
Yeah.
Oh, we are? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I thought it was the sound.
Give it the program. Yeah. Where's the flag? Throw the flag.
Both of them.
Jesus Christ. All right, but yeah. Strohs, what I say about Aaron Rodgers last week, he's on his Jordan Love fuck you tour. I think the Strohs are on their cheating fuck you tour. And frankly, the Twins, whoever the Twins play.
Twins are who we thought they were.
Come on. What is it, like 18? Like
18 straight. Ridiculous. 18 straight playoff losses.
They should just stop making the playoffs.
They're a regular season team only.
They should just stop making the playoffs. That's but it. Bad blood.
Yeah, let's come to the Yankees.
Yeah, maybe. But I think.
200 this year. I don't know if you want them.
It's a short season. But like I said, I like that they're on a mission. Even though they weren't the best team in the regular season, they still are the defending AL champs. They still have Correa. They still have Bregman. They still have Springer. Altuve, we'll see what he is. Obviously, he didn't have the best year. But Correa, still my guy. Like I told you, like I was in Tennessee, I did like that. He's still bae. But it's going to be a heated series. The A's are a scrappy team. I can't wait. I think that series goes five as well. I think the Braves. With their hitting, beat the Marlins in four, and I like the Dodgers in five in a series that I think we're gonna see a brawl because Manny Machado and fucking
Fernando Tatis
are fucking backflipping the shit.
He's got a little cockiness.
Backflipping everything, and if there's one guy likes to backflip as much as Fernando Tatis,
I love it.
It's Manny Machado.
I love it.
So I think the Dodgers.
Why do you guys think they did that?
They want to have that extra confidence that listen, we're not scared of anybody, and we can do this to anybody.
And listen, Manny Machado forever will be my guy. for saying fuck Boston. Like, those guys are scumbags over there.
Who do you like more, Machado or Correa?
Correa. But that's my pick. I hope the Yankees prove me wrong. Like I said, I'll wear this mask the whole show if they win. And maybe
that's like
I come full gear. Like, I haven't worn a jersey, so
Pete saying that the Braves are gonna lose. Come on,
I'll wear the jersey. I'll wear the mask and the hat if they beat the Rays. There we go. I think Hop agrees with me.
I'm gonna go with the Yankees to win their series. I think they'll win the series in four. The reason why is because it's the playoffs. They've never been in the playoffs. Rays have done well against them during the regular season, but playoffs is a completely different story. Rays haven't been here against the Yankees. They haven't had to face the aura facing New York in the playoffs, which is a different type of aura. So I'm going to say the Yankees are going to win that in four. I think whoever wins game one is going to have a huge advantage, because if Rays win game one, then they're going to be like, yeah, we do own these guys. We've beaten them all year, and now we're beating them in the playoffs. If the Yankees win game one, then it's going to be in the Rays' head like, all right, this is a different thing. This is a playoffs. Maybe we can't beat them like this. So game one, I think, whoever wins game one, I think is going to win the series.
Does Garrett Cole pitch game one and two?
I think that would be impossible.
Why?
Because his arm will fall off. But I think
he can do it.
I think they will go against the Astros. I think the Astros will find a way to get by Oakland. Even though Oakland, the reason I picked the White Sox, but Oakland won because they were close games. And all year, all Oakland's done is have low-scoring games where their bullpen has pitched well and they get a home run late. That's what they've done the whole year. So they have a playoff-style type team. But I think the Astros' experience of being deep in the playoffs and everything... Right. I think that's going to help push them above Oakland. With no Verlander. During this postseason, I don't think pitching is as important as it is in previous postseasons. The reason why is because it's like almost a continuation of the regular season right now. You're so closely into the season. You're only 60 games in. Some of the hitters haven't gotten a chance to get in their heat zone after 100 games. Pitchers haven't been able to get in the field of baseball the way they usually do because they've only had 12 starts instead of 30 starts. So.
I kind of disagree, though, because I think the deeper that we get into the postseason this year, especially because of the format, because there's no days off, you know, everything's back-to-back-to-back-to-back. I think it's going to be really, really important.
He said land the plane.
I think as we get deeper into the playoffs, I think they'll get more. We'll see the score again. As you said, maybe they'll get a little bit lower. The pitchers will get a little better. But we're still in the second round of playoffs. We're only three games in. I think offense is still going to control and pitching may not be as much. But I do think playing back-to-back-to-back, that means you're going to have to show the depth of your rotation.
Ooh, yeah.
You have to have four starters. You're not going to be able to just... you can't just have a one and two. I think so that's Astros and Yankees on one side. On the other side, the Braves, I just think that they have too much offense for the Marlins. I just don't think they'll be able to have enough pitching to slow down that lineup. Acuna had a good series. Freeman had a good series. Ozuna and Duvall didn't. Neither one of them didn't, but they still found a way to win that series. So, and then I think they'll go against the Dodgers just because I think the Dodgers I think right now they've played the best team. They've been the best team in baseball so far this year, and I think I want to see the Braves versus Dodgers. I think they're the two best teams in the NL.
That's going to be a great series.
So you see the Dodgers passing Padres?
Yeah, I think they will beat the Padres.
That fucking line?
I think they'll beat them in five.
Okay.
I think it'll be a five-game series.
What are your thoughts on Clayton Kershaw and his performance? Do you see a choke in his future?
Listen, I don't think so. I think...
Wow!
I think he comes up big for the Dodgers this year. Listen, it's now or never. I mean... This is going to be the defining moment of his career, pretty much.
Say, fuck you, man.
He's got an opportunity to bring a championship to L.A. He's got a good offensive line to do it. You know, like Pete said, I mean, listen, I viewed the same thing. They're probably the best team, all-around team, you know, in this league, the whole league this year. So, we'll see. I think he comes up big this year.
All right, here's the thing I'll say about this.
He picked the Dodgers.
Here's the thing I said.
The Dodgers won the whole thing.
Here's the
what
thing
the fuck
I
have you been? You've been sleeping?
He's been trying to get the YouTube to work.
Stop drinking so much Bacardi.
Wow. You're the only one drinking right now.
Listen.
The Dodgers, you know who the Dodgers are? They're like the Cowboys. They're nice and
pretty. No, the Cowgirls.
Wow.
Damn.
Wow.
Cowgirls.
I put money on. I put money on them today, so I'm not going to disrespect.
He showed up as soon as he said that.
As soon as he said that.
Listen, the Dodgers, the Dodgers are like, there you go, Dak Prescott.
Don't call him cowgirl.
The Dodgers are like the Cowboys. They look nice on paper all the time. However, the games have to be played. And at the end of the day, yeah, Garrett, what was his name? Clayton Kershaw?
Garrett. Jason Garrett.
Jason Garrett. Jason Garrett. That's another story. Oh, at the end of the day, until you prove it to me, I don't trust you. And Dodgers are proven. The Dodgers are proven time and time again. How many times have they been in the World Series the last 2 years?
Too many.
Too many. Too many.
Three. Too many. Three.
Too many. Too many to not to come right, home with right. the crown. Yeah. Maybe Mookie Betts is the difference maker. Oh, yeah. Maybe it's because Clayton Kershaw isn't the number one guy anymore. But I still have to see it. And I think that I think the road to the World Series is tough for them. Padres and then the Braves, more likely than not. Yeah. That's a tough trick. That's a tough trick. And
that was Dave, Matt, by the way. Talking about the Cowboys.
So I still have to see
Matt.
It.
Matt.
Yo,
he's
Matt.
Watching us live.
You're Matt, you're late, bro.
Yeah, for real. You're
late. You're late, bro. You're supposed to do the music for us before we started.
Oh, that's right. That would have been perfect. Really? Come on.
Bro. Unbelievable. What do you put?
What the hell?
Fuck it, Matt. All right.
The band got to do a song for us. So that'd be the intro.
So here we go. COVID-19. Yeah. And we knew this was going to be a possibility. Fuck, we knew this was going to happen because there isn't an NFL bubble.
Yeah.
They're letting fans in. I mean, if you saw the Georgia Auburn game yesterday,
yeah, there's a lot.
There were like 20,000 people in there.
Yeah, there was a lot of fans there.
So, y'all president got the COVID. So I'm gonna let that be. But now, Titans Steelers postponed because somebody was out on Broadway in Nashville. Yeah,
the coaches. It was actually the coach that got it.
That's on your team, bro. I don't know.
Right? Man. I don't know,
what
man.
Are they doing?
And then Cam Newton. Cam Newton went out with Robert Kraft of the massage parlors. That's how he got it. And then somebody from the Saints, you know, went on Bourbon Street, and that's how he got it. Pete. It's crazy, right? Stay indoors.
Bourbon Street, Nashville.
And then massage parlor somewhere in New England.
Oh,
somewhere in Foxborough.
I
think
we're
Boston.
Supposed to be doing this.
It's unbelievable how baseball and NBA are following the protocol, not the NFL.
Well, baseball started terribly, yeah. But the NBA has got to be given credit for the bubble, NHL.
And I was about to say NHL.
And MLS.
Pete, I mean,
fucking Titans.
I don't watch that shit, man.
Titans started the whole fucking COVID shit, man.
So speak on what happened to your team, man.
Listen, the coach and a practice player got COVID last week. With who?
Did Rudy show up there?
Which Rudy? What are you talking about?
Utah?
Were you with Sam this weekend?
Nobody was there. No.
Sam was getting chased around.
So those two, that coach and that player from the practice squad seems to have spread it to the team. And who knows if they did break protocol or not, but usually we saw with the Marlins, we saw with the Cardinals that it can last up to a week where people start popping up positive after that. And this, which is why I think it's dangerous for them to play the New England game, because even though there have been no positive tests yet, like, we may have one in 2 days, and then it spreads from there from that game, and then it spreads to two teams. So I don't think they should play, but, I mean, so far, they look like they're going to play.
Well, what about the Saints game? They got the news yesterday, right?
And yeah, but an update. Did. Update, though.
What was the update?
The guy tested again that tested positive, and he tested negative, so they think it was a false positive.
Man, that's just good. that's just Goodell throwing money.
And nobody else tested negative, so they're going to
That's play. Roger Goodell going,
bullshit.
they're already in Detroit. We can't cancel this game. So how about Cam Newton? I mean, big game. The Patriots coming off a victory and playing the Seahawks just as good as the Cowboys. They're 2-1 facing the defending champs. Marquee game. Cam Newton looking like he's back. And then he hangs out with Robert Kraft at the massage parlors. Gets COVID. And now they might go Brian Hoyer. I mean, talk about what's going on. I mean, any news? Like, what are we doing here, man?
Call me crazy, but I think it's a conspiracy.
Is it?
I think this is planned. I think this is all planned. All planned by New England, all planned by Kraft. I don't know what the hell is going on.
Should he play? Remember, this is the most important position.
This is what I think of that, Dave. What the fuck is he talking about?
Should Cam play?
Nah, I'm just kidding.
Quarterbacks, they talk in the huddle. spreading all that shit to the other players.
No.
Dave didn't take his meds.
Nah, I'm just kidding, guys. No, in all honesty, I mean, you know, any one of us can get it, depending on, you know, the precautions that we're taking, you know, what we're exposing ourselves to. You know, it's unfortunate, obviously, because, you know, just like Vic said, it was going to be a great matchup. You know, I think Cam, you know, coming to, you know, New England, to this new offense, it was going to be great to see a matchup, you know, against, you know, Patty Mahomes and the, you know, Kansas City Chiefs.
Patrick.
Yeah, that's right. Sorry, Mom. Patrick
you.
Holmes.
Yeah.
Patrick Holmes.
Baby daddy.
But,
yeah.
But listen, in all honesty, you know, I just hope that the NFL has the proper protocol, you know, in place, you know, to handle these things. Because these things, we talked about it in the beginning. When COVID came, we started talking about sports. You know, the earlier episodes that we had, you know, virtually, you know, what is the plan? What's the plan B? What's the plan C? What's the plan D? Because, you know, you have to assume this is going to happen.
Yeah.
You know, NHL.
They definitely got to open up week 18.
Yeah, hats off to the NBA and NHL because they had a great plan. Great plan. Obviously, you know, the NFL didn't follow 100% suit in what they did. And what they were able to accomplish, because some owners in states where shit's open
want that money.
Yeah, but plus
so that's what it is.
But plus another thing with the bubbles and stuff like that, like NHL, NBA, they have half the amount of players that you're going to have on an NFL team. So that's a lot more players you got to be responsible for.
So put it in four then.
It's a good point.
Put it in four states.
But again,
you still got to travel. Yeah. I thought the best idea, my idea, was just have a bubble in each NFL city, and have you when you travel, you only stay in that hotel. When you travel, you only go to the other hotel. You pretty much are isolated.
But he's right. I mean, money will dictate everything.
I mean, at the end of the day,
I hate to say it,
there's more football fields. There's more football fields in Texas.
More money, no problem.
Yeah.
Than there fucking is anything in this world. So you could have put everybody in Texas.
Yeah,
I don't care.
Yeah.
I guess there's a football field.
Each block.
So guys, I mean, in all honesty,
and since there's no fans, you can have it in high school.
Well, there's fans. There's because Texas is open.
With the contact too that football players are having and all that stuff. I mean, it was about to happen. I hate to say that. But listen, it was going to happen. Hopefully, the correct protocol is
Baker Mayfield
in place. Yes.
Will the season end early? What are your thoughts on that? Like,
I don't think it'll end early. I think they're going to add a week 18 so that if we have more cancellations, that they'll be able to have that extra game and they can push every wild card game and every divisional game back 1 week, and then they just won't have a week between the conference championships and the Super Bowl. So they'll have that extra week to do it. And plus, if it is another early incident, like what happened with the Titans this year, they can move around the buys and stuff like that. So
I was about to say that, too. Like, yeah, the buys can be moved around.
So you'll have one to two chances.
Maybe a Thursday game or something like that, depending on, you know, we're at during the week. But there's a lot
for them to shut it down, it would have to be, like, four or five teams, not just one or two.
I don't know, man.
It's a test for this sport.
We're gonna be seeing football every single night pretty soon.
I mean, I'm down with that though. I'm down with seeing a game every night. Right. I'm cool with that. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday night football, Friday night football.
Yep.
Whew. I mean, I'm down with that. Like, what else are we doing? Seriously, like,
you gotta be flexible.
We're outdoor dining. We're outdoor dining, freezing our asses off.
Yeah. Look what's happening in college football. They changed around the schedules twice already because teams said, all right, we're not going to play. Then we're going to play. All right, we're only going to play within the conference. All right. So everything's changing. So you just got to be adaptable. You got to be flexible to it.
All right. Well, hopefully this is just a blip in the radar. Obviously, your fantasy football teams are affected heavily.
Killing me.
I have Chiefs, Patriots, I have Titans,
Many Chiefs, man. Kelsey, Clyde, Hellerson-Lowe, too many Chiefs.
So that's going to suck. I know Dave is he's hurt. He's got I don't think he's drafted anyone. Did he draft anyone?
You got the Chiefs defense.
I had the Chiefs defense, but I dropped them. So. I dropped them,
goddamn
it. Damn. Are you playing Dre?
Playing
Dre? Where is Dre?
Oh, yeah, Dre's not here either. He's late.
Yeah, my team's not playing, so I'm not coming on.
He's somewhere in Cartagena or something like that.
Remember what happened last week? He showed up late. The Steelers were losing when he showed up.
They can't lose now. They're not playing. All right, so moving on.
Cartagena.
Moving on to what we call football in the state of New Jersey. I'm going to leave Buffalo out of this.
But they're part of New York, though.
Well, I said New Jersey.
Yeah, New Jersey.
New Jersey.
So I'm teams that play in New Jersey.
I feel so bad because nobody really considers them like, you know.
So I'm not going to. I'm
not stupid.
Gonna, no, I don't want to say it. I feel bad.
They play in New Jersey.
We play in New Jersey.
No, I mean, you know, Buffalo, like. I don't know. People yeah, really
consider this a different.
A real New York.
Right. Yeah, it's like a 6-hour drive.
Well, I'll
give you a 30-second lesson. It's a different metropolitan area. So, New York City.
That's
counts part of North Jersey, as Philadelphia counts part of South Jersey. So, Buffalo, it's its own metropolitan area. And that's something you won't learn in college. Well, actually, I did learn in college. But whatever. Which New Jersey team is worse? Yeah. We both suck. Jets and Giants. So, let's write down our answers. You're supposed to do it at the same time, Pete.
No, I wasn't right. I wrote something else.
All right, so on three.
But do you want to still?
Which New York team is worse? Giants
this
or Jets?
This
one for
your little
the nugget. The more you know. All right. So,
Matias sucks more.
On three, whenever you're ready.
All right.
And count the votes, Hawk.
One.
Is it on three or after?
And three. One, two, three.
Just making sure.
What are the votes?
2-1 Giants.
Motherfucker.
Yeah. That's right.
Yeah.
How can you not see how terrible the New York football Giants are, David?
Because both of them are bad, but the Giants are playing with their starters. They're missing Barkley right now, but the Jets are missing their entire team. They don't have their top three starting wide receivers. They don't have their starting running back. They don't have like one of their offensive linemen. The Giants are playing with most of their people except for two guys, Shepard and Saquon. And they still can't freaking move the ball against a backup team in the San Francisco 49ers.
We did move the ball.
We did. We just didn't score.
You got to score. I don't care how much you move the ball.
You play to win the game. You don't play to move the ball from the 25 to the 20.
You have to score to win the game.
Basically. I think the Giants are worse, and here's why. Jason Garrett's horrible.
Yes.
As soon as we brought Jason Garrett on board, I said, we're going to suck. So that's gone. Joe Judge, inexperienced head coach.
Yeah.
Listen, will he be a great coach sometime down the road? Maybe. But to have Jason Garrett as the guy that's backing him up,
no,
not going to work. No. If you saw with Dallas, you see what Dallas has been for the last 15 years. Mediocre at best. Nice on paper, mediocre at best. The Giants aren't even mediocre. They're fucking horrible. So we can't even be 8-8.
And I told you,
until we win a game, I will not wear fucking Giants gear on the show. And I don't think we're going to win a game this year.
They're close to your 0-5. They're close to your prediction.
Well, it's going to be 0-4 tonight. It's going to be 0-4 today. Rams are going to whatever the spread is, could be 58.
It's
I'm betting the Rams.
It's going to be bad.
58. If the spread is 58, I'm betting the Rams.
Yes, really, Dave.
Defense is horrible.
Really bad.
I'm sorry. I have to bring this up.
What?
You guys are the ones that said, hey, yeah, your defense doesn't have that many holes. It's all right. No, and our defense is horrible?
I said the front seven is decent.
They're missing key pieces.
Now we're not missing people. So.
No, they have some talented players, but they're missing a lot of key pieces.
Front seven is good. The big boys up front.
We need another middle
Lorenzo
linebacker.
Lorenzo Carter's good.
Yeah.
I don't like Carter.
We need a lot of everything.
He's all right. He's not JPP. He's not OC. He's not, you know, definitely not even close to Michael Strahan, right?
No way.
Not Justin Tuck.
Oh, absolutely.
Right? But he's there. He gets pressure, right? We haven't had anything. We don't have shit. We don't have a pass rush, right? Our fucking general manager, who after this year, I think should be fired, passed up on Josh Allen.
Yeah, I don't like him.
Mm. Look at Josh Allen. He might play for the sorry-ass Jaguars, but he's still getting sacks. I'm over it. I hope we lose every fucking game and we fucking get Trevor Lawrence. That's it. You see?
So what are we going to do with Dan Jones?
I don't fucking care.
Number two? We're going to go number two. Big fired up.
I'm angry. I'm frank. It's been 4 years, bro. It's been 4 years. It's been 4 years of this shit, man.
Yeah.
You're the New York Giants. You're the fucking third or fourth most valuable franchise in all of football. Top 6, 7 in all of sports. And this is the shit you're putting out there? Yeah. I'm over it. I'm fucking over it. Draft Trevor Lawrence. I don't give a fuck. Go 0-16. I'm over it.
So, Dave, why'd you pick on the Jets?
So, I picked the Jets because I'm going to trump you guys here.
Whoa. We're going to throw the fucking flag.
Adam Gates.
Hold on.
You know, they thought bringing this offensive wizard.
They're not one coach away from me.
You know, they made all these moves, right? Yeah. They made all these moves. They spent all this money.
But that actually works in our favor.
Who was supposed to have a good team this year? All the money, how much money did they spend?
They still weren't supposed to be good.
Oh, okay, regardless, how much money did they spend then? So why spend all that money then?
Because you have to.
To make your team, you know, what you think is going to be, you know, a good team, let's say.
They were that far away.
Listen, Sam Darnold looked so good last year. You had all the Jets fans saying, oh, yeah, geez. The Giants passed up on him. They made a mistake. And now what? So listen, I just think, like I told you, I disagreed with you guys when I said
you didn't see the run that he made on Thursday. LeBron James tweeted at him.
I know he was great. He was awesome. I just think that the Giants defense. You're right. I'm going to agree with you. We suck. I mean, we have. I think we have a lot of holes.
We made Nick Mullins.
We can't get pressure on a third, fourth string quarterback. You know, who lost like half their team. I mean, it's ridiculous. So I'll agree with you on that. Yes, you know, injuries have played a big role on both teams, but I just think that the Jets. In my head, maybe I'm wrong. I thought they were supposed to be a better team than the Giants this year. So, yes, they've had their rash of injuries, but you have all sorts of stuff going on over there, especially with Le'Veon Bell and the drama, the hamstring, okay. Adam Gase. It's like a circus over there.
All right.
So I think they're a worse team, maybe not by much, because the Giants are definitely probably almost as bad, but I think they're a worse team than us, and I think they're worse off. I think, if anything, we have a better future going forward. I think there's a lot of things that can get done, but I do agree with you, the general manager. I mean, listen, this is a reflection of what he's built. He has not done his job. Joe Judge, maybe I'd give him maybe one or two more years. This is only his first year. So one or two more years to see what he can do. I like what I've heard from him, but yeah, no results have happened.
I'll put this on you.
This season, that's it.
If you're the Jets or the Giants, you finish 0-16. Do you take a quarterback?
Do I think they'll do it?
How about we do it? How about if it's us? All right, so let's go.
What are we doing?
Let's go us for the Jets first.
Okay, Jets. So Jets.
Do they take Trevor Lawrence or not?
They take Trevor Lawrence. Do the Jets take Trevor Lawrence?
The Jets.
And I don't think the Jets fans even want Trevor Lawrence.
Okay, ready?
So ready. Let's see. What's the score?
No.
Hey. I think they'll take him.
Okay.
I think the Jets will take him.
Do the Giants take Trevor Lawrence?
Oh, this was easy.
Sunshine.
One. Oh, ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three.
Yeah, this was really
cool. Wow. 2-1. No.
Oh, who said no? What the hell?
They're not going to take him.
They're going to...
I'll say one caveat.
It's going to be like the new show.
If Gettleman is officially fired, then yes,
they'll take him. That's exactly what I was going to say.
They'll take him, yeah. But if Gettleman's still there, right, they're not going to take him.
So now, if we're either the Jets or the Giants, do we take Trevor Lawrence? If it's us.
Do the Jets first?
Are we doing Jets?
Yeah, the Jets.
We'll put them both on the same time.
All right, so I'm going to put Jets on the top.
Jets on top, Giants on the bottom. Do we take Trevor Lawrence with this first round pick?
For the first round pick?
All right, Jets on top.
Ready?
Hold on.
What day? You're running paragraphs?
Yeah. I'll make an explanation.
Ready? One, two, three.
No.
Jets on top.
Yes. Hell yes.
There you go.
What? You don't take him if you're the Jets?
Yo, you want me to replace my boy Samuel?
Oh, yeah. I knew it. I knew it. See, now the truth comes out. All it takes is time, ladies and gentlemen.
I like
it. The truth will come out in due time. So,
finally admits it.
That's cool, though.
I like it.
All right, so
it was your fault that you had mom.
We're not going there.
No. But it was his fault that he actually looked decent this week.
We're not going there. No.
All right.
So all right. Take him to the club. Tell him, yo, that girl.
He gave him some vitamins. He gave him some vitamins this week.
B12.
I'm not saying anything. I'm gonna stay out of that one. I just know Pete likes to hang out with Sam Darnold. That's it. I don't know what happens afterwards.
You gotta get him on our show, man. Come on.
Yeah, y'all talk about it so much.
I like the guy. He's good. All right, so we have 10 minutes left. So let's go. Let's talk about games to pick. Interesting game to pick.
Ah, there you go.
1 o'clock game. I think the most important 1 o'clock game. Oh, I don't want to say it.
Bad, but
it's pretty bad. I'm gonna go.
It's supposed to be Titans versus Steelers.
I'm gonna go Browns. I'm gonna go Browns Cowboys.
That's the one I was looking forward to.
Browns Cowboys is the most probably looked at 1 o'clock game.
Yeah.
Let's put our picks up.
Because of fantasy or?
What?
So let's do the
team
spread.
And how much they win by.
The spread is 3.5. So let's go win and cover.
Okay, win and cover.
What say you? Let's go. Win and cover on three. One. Two, three.
Dallas by five.
So yes.
Boys by yes. Cowboys yes. They cover.
I think we're all in agreement there. Yeah, I think the Browns are terrible.
I don't know. Yeah.
You
mean they're not better with Odell
with
Beckham?
The commercial guy
and Landry?
You know what's funny?
That guy in the commercial.
You know what's funny about all this? Remember when Odell was on the Giants and he was like, "Oh, Odell's the one that's extending Eli's career." Maybe it was Eli that made Odell better. Just saying.
Maybe Baker's cutting his career.
Also a good point. All right, so I'm going to take one more game from the 1 o'clock because I think it's interesting and a lot of people are saying it's interesting.
Really?
Seahawks and Dolphins. Some reason, the spread is 5.5, but for whatever reason, I've seen a lot of experts saying that this is a trap game for the Dolphins, for the Seahawks, and that 5.5 might be a little too much. So let's put down who wins and if they cover. Interesting. So let's do it. Dave again is writing a paragraph.
Yeah, sorry. I have to write an explanation.
3, 2, 1. Oh, shit.
Oh, fumble, Ruski.
Why? Seahawks by 10. Hawks, yes. Fuck yes. They do fucking cover. Damn.
Why are people...
I said yes, they cover. I'm crazy.
Why do you think the people are taking the Dolphins?
I have no idea, to be honest with you. I don't know if because they fell into the Fitzmagic drama or whatever.
Maybe Tua's starting. I don't know. We don't know.
No, he's not. But maybe people fell into the Fitzpatrick magic, but I don't get it. I don't get it.
There's no bye. I mean, maybe a bye if there was a bye. But, really?
Man, it's 4 o'clock.
Say wave bye to the
4 o'clock games are brutal, too, man. This is it.
Because they took out the KC New England game. That was supposed to be the
week. Why'd you pick this week to premiere the basement?
The Titans, because it was supposed to be the week that the Titans beat the shit out of the Steelers. That's why.
Brutal. All right.
Yeah, Dre.
Yes, Dre, we said.
All right, so I'm going to go with two games that might be interesting. First, we'll go Colts, Bears. Bears favored by 3. So, who are you picking and are they covering? I'm going to go. Oh, this is easy for me. I don't even know why I'm messing
up. I know why this is easy.
So I don't know why I'm messing around.
I know exactly where he's going with this.
All right, so ready? One, two, three.
Bears, Spoon Rivers, Bears, cover, Colts, yes.
Colts?
Yes.
Are you picking them to win?
Yes.
So not even the spread. You're not even taking the 3 points. You're picking them to win. Why?
Yes, because I just think they're you know, the better team. I know Nick Foles is starting. I'm starting this week, but what Nick Foles are we going to see? Are we going to see
the Super Bowl champions? There's only one Nick Foles. The Super Bowl champions.
He was great in Jacksonville.
Hold on, hold on.
In Jacksonville, they ruined people.
Hold on. Week one, he threw a 50-yard bomb where he got fucking murdered on the throw. Touchdown. That was the Nick Foles we knew. And then he came back from injury. Had one bad game, and then for whatever fucking reason, what was one bad game? Daniel Jones has 19 fucking bad games. He's still our starter.
Yeah, he's your rookie. Come on.
So you take
a second sophomore.
All right. So Tom Brady has a bad game. You taking him out?
Tom Brady's.
Yeah. He's
Tom
a Super Brady's Bowl. Tom Brady. He's the Super Bowl MVP. Yeah. This is why Jacksonville sucks and will always suck.
Yeah.
Right? You got Gardner Minshew? I'm like, because he's got a fucking cool mustache? Fuck that, man. Listen, Nick Foles might not be...
I know you're biased because it's Nick Foles.
No, yeah. Because Nick Foles never got a chance in Jacksonville.
He's
proven it. He started like four games and they benched him. All
right.
He started four games.
He gets a chance.
I'm playing a violin right now.
He gets a chance in Philadelphia. What does he do? What does he do in Philadelphia? What are you doing in Philadelphia? He wins the Super Bowl, leads into the playoffs. Gets a chance. Let me throw in Mitchell Trubisky. The Bears somehow win with the incompetence of Mitchell Trubisky. And last week, they're down 10 points. Matt Nagy's like, damn, fucking Trubisky sucks. I got to go with Nick Foles. And what does Nick Foles do? Lead him to victory.
Yeah.
It's that simple.
All right, out of four.
All right, so... Other four.
Rivers sucks.
Rivers does suck. The Buffalo Bills versus the Raiders. Buffalo's favorite 3.5.
Las Vegas got this shit.
So, ready? 1, 2, 3.
Raiders, Bills 3. Bills, yes, they fucking cover.
Really? I got the Raiders. Yeah,
all right, well,
you do the curse word, bro.
I'm going to go Bills, and they don't cover. I think they're going to win by a field goal. I'm not sure why. I just have a feeling. There's no really an explanation behind it.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm
3-0 picking the Bills as they are 3-0, because I picked the Bills last week against both these guys and their L.A. Rams pick.
Well, they should have won. Come on.
So why do you think the Bills is fucking right?
I like what Josh Allen's doing this year with him and Stephon Diggs. Listen, like you guys said, you know, last week and the week before, I think the Bills got it right, man. I think he probably is the best in that class, and he's showing it. He's just got to stop doing that, you know, Mafia Madness stuff, jumping in the air. He's crazy, but listen, their defense,
Mafia Madness.
Their defense looks good. I like where they're going with this team. I like Josh Allen a lot. So, Las Vegas, I think, you know, I know they've had a decent season so far, but I'm really not sold on that defense. I'm really not sold on Carr either. So we'll see. And I think it's going to show this week, especially with that, you know, Mafia coming through, baby. So,
you picked the Raiders.
Yeah.
Why?
Because I think Josh Jacobs is going to have a huge game. I think
Gruden
is one of those people that he's an old school coach. He likes the running game, and I think he's going to go back to the running game because they struggled last week. If you go back to what they were at the start of the season, like when they beat up on the Saints on Monday Night Football, this is a completely different team than what we saw last week. So I think he's going to get back to the running with Josh Jacobs and win it that way.
All right, so we got 2 minutes left. We're going to go through the speed round for the three remaining games left. Sunday night, 49ers-Eagles. 49ers are 9-point favorites. Let's write it down. And briefly, why?
Man, you was down 4-1.
All right, let's go. 3, 2, 1, Dave. Pete just did it.
Eagles, Niners, Niners, no.
Don't cover. All right, so we agree on that. That's a big line. I'm betting the Eagles. I don't think they're that bad like the Giants to lose 36 points. All right, so minute 30 left. Falcons, Packers. Packers, 6.5-point favorites. What do you got, Pete?
Packers, yes.
Packers. Everyone, yes.
Everyone covers. All right, so there you go. This is like a Pete's corner with all our
inputs. Like
so, Dre, you're fired.
Yeah, Dre.
All right, and then if they decide to play this game this week, Patriots, Chiefs, Chiefs getting 11.
Stop texting, Dre.
Is that Dre? Dre heard us. He's fired.
Chiefs, no. By 7.
Yes. No, they got a cheat.
Do they cover?
Yes.
Oh, they cover?
Yeah.
11? You say you're going to bet them.
Yeah, but they don't have Cam.
Man.
All right, if Cam was playing, I would pick New England to win money line.
Listen. Whoa,
but without Cam, really? Cam, I think KC is going to go nuts on him.
I think if Jarrett Stidham plays, they only lose by 7.
Yo, real quick, how many touchdowns did Russell Wilson throw today?
Woo!
Four.
I'm going to say only 3.
Okay.
I'm gonna say only 3.
Like
but if Hoyer plays, it's they win by 17. So 10 seconds left. That's our show for the week. We'll be back next Sunday. Hopefully, we'll be come back to the basement. We'll have better games. But until then, we'll see you next week.
Peace.
Orale, mi gente. We love you. Orale, mi gente.